I wanted to say that as CFA is the gold standard in investment management, CFP is the gold standard in personal finance. And personal finance impacts everybody, yes, whether you are an engineer, whether you are somebody working in any other industry, a doctor or scientist or finance. Everybody needs to manage their own personal finances, or they need to learn with their help or hire a financial planner who can guide, give a roadmap. So CFP is the gold standard in personal finance. KEYUR Bhai is a Ramakant Achrekar in personal finance coaching space. So I'm a CFA Chartered Holder. I have over 14 years of working experience in financial services. Of 12 of them have been in United Kingdom working in different asset management companies, like multinational companies. I've spent a lot of time during this part working on investment analysis, research, portfolio analysis and risk analysis of mutual funds. After pursuing my career for a long time in financial services, I've decided to come back. I'm back in India now and pursuing a course in personal finance, something that has been of my key interest for over a long time. While I was researching on how to go about, you know, learning this course, Certified Financial Planner, being one of the best course or the world's best in international course certification in personal finance, I came across the name KEYUR SHAH as a coach, as a mentor for this particular certification. So it has been a great journey so far with KEYUR SHAH.
Okay, thank you, Bhavik Bhai. It's our pleasure that you are with us. You are a CFA Chartered Holder, you are an experienced professional, and I would like to indirectly address some of the thought the experienced professional or finance professional have, like I'm a CFA Chartered Holder or I'm a CA, I'm MBA finance, why I need to do a CFP certification.
I think there are multiple reasons one should do this, so if I'll go one by one. So if you are a CFA Chartered Holder or even an MBA finance, there is some element of personal finance covered in CFA Chartered Holder in level 1. There's a great detail in level 3 as well. But none of them talk specifically about the financial in India. Okay. So if you are somebody who is living in India, staying in India, there are the product specific information, knowledge, you can read some, pick up some books and get it. But how to build that all together from an Indian context perspective is not covered within CFA as well. There are a lot of basics. There are a lot of the theory of retirement corpus, etc., is covered in CFA. But when you want to bring it down to how you can connect a product with suitable for a retiree or somebody who's planning to build their retirement corpus, for example, PPF or any other debt mutual fund, then doing CFP based on Indian... So CFP is a global program, don't get me wrong, but it's based on the local content. So that is a very key factor or the differentiator of CFP, doing it from FPSB India specifically. And even within MBA finance, it is a lot of about business management. It has nothing to do with personal finance. There may be some elements of financial analysis, but if you would ask the MBA finance in terms of which products, you know, they'll tell you equity or mutual fund, but nobody will be able to calculate an inflation adjusted corpus. What is required for somebody to retire, what is required for somebody to achieve financial freedom at a young age. We don't have to wait till the 60s to be on a vacation. You know, if you've got the right amount of corpus, right amount of money, you can be free tomorrow itself. So, yes. So personal finance helps us understand the products. It helps us understand how we can bring this all together and create a financial plan for yourself, for your family. You can help your friends and relatives as well, and thereby to the larger audience or the people in the country.
Good, very good. So if I summarize what Bhavik Bhai said, so when you do a MBA finance or CFA charter or maybe a CA, etc., so you more focus about the corporate finance or maybe some CA, especially regulatory and compliance. I'll not talk about the CA, I'll talk about MBA finance and CFA charter. It is more about the corporate finance or analysis, financial management, where here it is core focus is about the personal financial planning, where how I can sit with individual family and create the comprehensive financial plan. So what are the important goal of family, like retirement, children, higher education, vacation, how I can do a contingency planning, how I can help them to reduce their debt and achieve the freedom from paying a EMI, how I can help to save their tax or optimization of taxation. So indirectly, even I tell honestly, many of time I have seen that chartered accountant or MBA finance or CFA charter, okay, when they do it for themselves only, forget it the other profession, even for them benefit, if they do it, they will be able to take a right asset allocation call. Otherwise, we have seen that you have grown in traditional family, or basically your forefather or father, grandfather have mainly invested in a traditional product like real estate, gold or fixed deposit. Even though you are MBA finance or charter holder or CA, you likely to follow same one, na? Because you have seen that. So today even we have seen many of time people who are working in corporate finance, okay, may not have exposure in mutual fund. Okay, or have a minimum exposure investment in mutual fund. Forget the debt or equity, but the investment in mutual fund is on a lower side. So why? Because it is the, basically they do not have an idea. So now, Bhavik bhai, you have completed 3 months. You started in November, so November, December, Jan, almost 3.5 months is completed. So what are your key learning and how it is benefited you personally?
I think it has helped very much in understanding, first is the calculation corpus, which is very important to understand the retirement calculation, goal based for every other goal. And once you learn the principles of financial planning for one particular goal, that can be applied to a set of different goals. I've helped with this knowledge that I've gained, or the information I've shared with my friends and other relatives as well. It helps them understand, improve their financial situation. It has made them, help them become more literate, because in our country, as we all know, mis-selling is on a very high level, where as you go to any organization, any, whether it's a bank or even a mutual fund, even a LIC agent distributor, they will always sell us products which are connected with high commission. So the organization selling us is earning a high commission. The product may or may not be suitable for us. So it is important for us to understand whether it's the right product is suitable for us. I'm not against any insurance product, nor against any traditional asset classes like real estate or anything. However, it is important that whether it fits our asset allocation. It doesn't meet the criteria, doesn't meet our liquidity needs, is it suitable for the horizon that we are planning to invest for. So all those elements which are covered in CFA as well, and with the help of KEYUR SHAH's video learning courses, it has made a lot of things more clearer in mind. It helps me understand, and I've been able to guide a couple of young freshers as well, who are trying to understand what should be the right course of direction in terms of what certification they should take in the future. So with these benefits, what I've shared with them, I'll be pleased to say that one of the two or three people I spoke has agreed, has understood the benefits, and will be very sure shortly joining the video learning coaching as well to take her career forward in the future.
Good, very good, excellent. So now if you have to share one or two, you can say personal benefit you have shared, but corrective decision or some of the decision you took in last 3-4 months. So what are the one or two, three decision you took after going through the video lectures?
So I have personally realized, or actually it got a confirmation of what I had been thinking before. I have stopped paying premium for my endowment insurance plans. I have stopped paying premium for that because, as I realized, the amount of return that one can get is very low on those products. The amount of premium one has to pay to get a cover, for example, a 5 lakh policy could be 22,000 or something. So previously I had a 50 lakh cover which costed about 65,000 premium. Now I've applied for a higher term insurance with the same amount of premium, 10x the cover with the same amount of premium. So that has helped. It is important to secure my family's financial future. So this is one of the decisions that I have taken. I have reduced my home loan to a larger extent because this helps us understand the cost of interest that we are paying over a period of time. We should not invest when we have debt. So, you know, while we are investing, thinking of the can leverage, those sort of things are very dangerous, very risky. I've been away from day trading before as well, which is which has helped me to build my corpus. And now with this planning, I have been investing over a period of time. I've been managing my friends and family's mutual fund portfolio. However, they have been lacking goals. So all those portfolios that we've managed have been not with, based on goals, but now I can allocate those investments to the right goals, and then we can make a decision when to, you know, review an asset allocation, etc. I've also encouraged my sister to surrender her ULIP plan. Previously, I was the one who had encouraged to buy it 10 years ago, and now that I've learnt the mistake that we've made, I've rectified that. We've surrendered the ULIP policy as well, and now, you know, looking for a better insurance plan.
Different. Good. Excellent. So, objective is very simple. Even if you are a finance professional, like MBA finance, okay, or you can say CFA Chartered Holder. So it talks about more onto a corporate side, okay, more into analysis of financial statement, or you can say investment banking, merger and acquisition, etc. But if you want to really want to prepare your own comprehensive financial plan, either you want to prepare yourself, then you need to go through the training, or you can hire someone who is a certified financial planner, okay, who can help you to prepare a comprehensive financial plan. So that's how you will be able to have a clarity, and you will be able to save more and save into right direction and achieve the goal. So the biggest differentiator when we say CFP certificate is investing first, basically having the clarity of goal, and then calculating the inflation adjusted corpus, calculating the SIPs required as per the asset allocation, and then product comes. So 80% focus is about the planning, and 20% is only on a product side. So today, even I don't like to even discuss which are the best mutual fund or average mutual fund. I said even if you invest in average mutual fund, it is expected to deliver 12% return. Then why you should waste your time in identifying which are the good or best mutual fund? Okay, those who having a minimum 5 years or 10 years plus and delivered the 12% average return, having a multi-cap blend portfolio. Okay, that we'll discuss tomorrow in detail. Okay, so we will upload a video by end of the February. So those who are watching this video and in Mumbai, okay, Bhavik Bhai is right now independent professional. He is also catering his CFA Chartered Consultancy, as well as help you in preparing your financial plan. So he will help you to prepare the comprehensive financial plan. Definitely, if there is a need required, he can consult the his mentor KEYUR SHAH or co-mentor Ankit Savla to make it more comprehensive. Yeah, even if you want to have prepared the fee only financial plan, so even we can help together with help of the Bhavik Bhai, Ankit and KEYUR SHAH to prepare your comprehensive you can say financial plan. So thank you very much, Bhavik Bhai.